try to prove yourself that the statement is true or not. When you're done, you can see in this video the main steps of a correct solution, and you can use this video to check whether your own answer is correct or not. So now our statement will be A in M times N matrix and B in N times N matrix, and then that AB equals that BA. Is this statement true or not? And we can use Theorem 1 if we like and the relevant definitions. So what is Theorem 1? Theorem 1 says that AB equals that A times that B, and matrix A is invertible if not only if the determinant is non-zero. Maybe we don't need it, but we can use it if we want. So let's try. So what can we do? I will want to prove that AB equals that BA. Well, we could use the following idea. We can use the theorem 1A, which says that AB equals that A times that B, then invert the order, and then use theorem 1A again. So is that a correct solution in your opinion? Now we need to be careful over here, because theorem 1A can only apply for N times N matrices, for square matrices. And in this case, we do not necessarily have square matrices. A may be M by N, and B may be N by M, and M is not necessarily equal to N. So can it be true at all? Well, take for example A 2 by 3 and B 3 by 2. So AB will give us a 2 by 2 matrix, and BA is 3 by 3 matrix. So we will end up with square matrices, so we can compute those determinants. At least the products are square. So far, so good. But are they equal, or are they always equal? Well, let's take a closer look into this problem. Let B be a 3 by 2 matrix. So B has two columns, B consisting of columns B1 and B2, both in R3. And let's assume for a moment that those two columns are independent. So that means if you compute B times a vector containing x1 and x2 to scalars, we get x1 times b1 plus x2 times b2, which is an element in the span of b1 and b2, which is an element in the plane spanned by b1 and b2. So that's what happens if you compute B times any vector. You get a vector in a plane spanned by the two columns of B. Now, what happens now if you compute B times matrix A? Now, definitions, B times A1, B times A2, B times A3. Now, B times A1 is B times A vector in R2. So this yields a vector in R3 in a plane spanned by B1 and B2. The same for B times A2 and the same for B times A3. So the three columns of B times A are all in the plane spanned by B1 and B2. And if B1 and B2 would be linear dependent, it's even worse, and they are all three on the line. So in particular, they are on all on a plane or in a line. In particular, the set of BA1, BA2, BE3 will be dependent because we have three vectors and they are all three in a plane, so they can never be independent. So your matrix B times A will always have dependent columns. So in particular, that means that the rank of B times A cannot be equal to 3. It has to be lower, either 2 or 1 or even 0. So that means in particular that the determinant of the matrix is always 0, because your B times A can be invertible. You can have at max 2 pivots or whatever. You can use an argument like that. So you know that the determinant of B times A is always 0, regardless of what matrices B and A you take, as soon as those sizes 3 by 2 and 2 by 3 are given. Now, why did we look into this? Well, this gives us an idea that our statement can never be true, because for one of the products, the determinant will always be 0, no matter what matrices A and B you take. And the other product, 2 by 3 times 3 by 2, will give a 2 by 2 matrix. It shouldn't be too difficult to find a non-zero determinant for that case. So what can you do? You can try to find the matrix A, 2 by 3, matrix B, 3 by 2. That BA is always 0, but now you can compute A times B, and you can try to find A and B such that this determinant is not equal to 0. It's not that difficult to find, by the way. I mean, if you would write down anything, it will probably already work. But always try to find a counterexample which is as easy as possible. So, for example, this example with this A, this B over here would already work. The debt of A times B equals 1 and the debt of B times A equals 0. So here you see that this statement debt AB equals debt BA for general M times N matrices is in general not true, because here we have a counterexample.